Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. My name is Claudio. So glad that you're here. If you're visiting for the first time, consider subscribing to the channel. Click the like button and share this video with your friends. For those of you returning, thank you as well. Today I'm sharing with you how you can outline images like this right here using the latest and greatest Adobe Express. So let's go ahead and dive right in. Here I'm at the home screen of Adobe Express, and what I'm going to do is click on the plus sign here in the top left corner, and I'm going to just go with the standard size of a square here for this project. Let's go ahead and close this out. I'll begin by choosing a background color, or you can add a background image, whatever you want. But for this demo, I'm just gonna use the background color here. And the next step is to import an image. You can go ahead and use stock images here, but since I wanna create this for myself, I'm going to search for my own image here. So let's go ahead and find a good one here that we can use to demo for this project. And I'm gonna find something with a background available here, something that I usually use in my project, something like this right here. So let's go ahead and bring this image in right here. You can see I have the background of my office here. So I'm gonna go ahead and resize that, make it a little bit larger to fit into this square right about there here. And then what I'll do is select the remove background option from the image menu over here on the left and let the Adobe AI run its magic. There we go. We've got a nice background removed here for this image. And let me just position my photo here. So here's the next step that you'll need to do here is with the photo selected, you want to duplicate that photo. So here we go up to the menu, the image menu. Once again, here we have the duplicate button. We'll click on that. And now I have the exact copy of that image with the background removed. I'm going to go ahead and click out here and select both images, and we'll go up here to align, and you will see these options. We will choose middle and center to make sure that both of these images are set right on top of each other. And with both of them selected, I'll just do some minor adjusting with my mouse here. We will move it to the left just to make sure that I have the entire image perfect. All right. Now, when you have images selected, you'll see your stacks over here or your layers on the top right, or they will show up over here on the right, depending on how many objects you have on the page. Now here, what I want to do is click out and then select the bottom image. And then for here, we have the image menu pop up once again. What I'm going to do next is choose the effects menu over here at the bottom. And then we are going to go with a duotone, but we will choose custom. And once you choose custom, you have your shadows and highlights. I'm going to make the shadow and highlight both white. Now, nothing will show up pretty much on the canvas over here. You see a little bit of a glow outside of my image, and that's because of the duotone effect. We're going to close that out. Now, here's the next step is we're going to size that up. We're going to increase that size. Again, we're just affecting the back image, the second layer over here. And this is gonna be a little bit of a adjustment, or I should say a maneuvering. We're gonna make this large enough so that we can make my head here, for example, fit nicely. So we'll do that. Depending on how much of a outline you want, this will just depend on your preference here. So I've got that right there. Now, if you notice, my shoulders are a bit a ways here, so that's okay. This is our next step. We're going to click the back arrow here and go back to the image menu. And what we're going to do is we're going to duplicate this once again. And so we'll do that. And now this is going to show up on the top layer. And what we'll need to do is grab that top layer and we're going to move that down either behind it or behind the other one. That's fine, which is okay. And what we're going to do next is, this is a little bit tricky here. We're going to select all the images. And then what you need to do is holding the shift button, click on the top most image. And that will make sure that you're only seeing the, or I should say you're only selecting the back two. So that's important. Then you come back to align here and we want to align those center wise and middle. And it's okay if it got off a bit, but that's fine. We're going to go ahead and now we're going to adjust those right there. Whoop, that was a little bit tricky. And so we're gonna select them all once more and then uncheck, or I should say shift and click the top. Now we can do this here. So as I was mentioning, a little bit maneuvering. All right, so we've got one image there. So these two are aligned and showing up. So now here's what we'll do. We'll click out and then we're going to click on the top second layer here. And what we'll do is we'll grab this handle right here in the middle. It looks like a little bar right there. We're going to move that up right about to where my shoulder shows up there. And then we'll grab, or I should say, click on the bottom one. And then what we'll do here is we will use the arrow key here to make that adjustment right about there. Now you'll see like, oh, what's going on with my head over there? It's showing up there, but that's okay. This is the bottom layer. We're going to grab that middle line once again, that bar, and we're going to slide that down. And there we go. Right about, should say right about there. So let's see, we'll click out. That's cool, that works. It takes a little bit of playing around, maybe take a minor adjustment here, fine tune this till you get it to where you want it to be. Let's see here. That's close enough right there. Again, this is going to take some time to make sure we got it right about where we want. That's pretty good right there. And then what we'll do here is we will select them all once again. And you could right here group the entire project and now it'll move all together. So now you can place this onto any other project. So the next step or tip I can share with you here is going back to the background color. You can click on background color and choose this here with no background. And then when you download it as a PNG, now it shows up as transparent. So that's a little quick tip there. So if you want to download this and superimpose it onto a video, to a graphic, just make sure you choose the background color with no color, like we're seeing here. And then you can download this as a transparent background, bring back the color if you want, and then download it like that. So when you're creating projects, you want to make sure that background color shows up if that's what you want. And there you have it.
And that's how to outline images in the latest and greatest Adobe Express. Now it's your turn to give it a try. If you have any comments or questions about this video, feel free to drop it into the chat below. Don't forget, hit that like button, subscribe, click the bell to be notified for future videos, and please share this video with your friends. Until next time, have fun creating and be good to one another. Peace.